Hey guys, welcome back to the channel and thanks a lot for joining me today. Now, there's a little bit of a problem in the music industry that I think we need to discuss. And that problem is people suing each other for frankly bullshit reasons. So, to give you an off-the-bat example, Katy Perry was sued for $2.8 million. $2.8 million for using 8 notes of a melody that had been used before. I think it was 8 notes, something like that. Now, this to me is horseshit. Now, recently I watched a TED Talk video, which I will link down below for anybody that wants to check that out. And it's about this very thing, melodies, hooks, you know, whatever. And this TED Talk goes on to say that they have created a program, an algorithm, which has made every single melody that could ever be made and ever will be made, and it's created these melodies. So what it basically breaks down to is there's about 12 notes that can possibly be used in a melody. Now, that means that there are only so many finite melodies in the world. In modern music today, with, you know, the absolutely massive history of recorded music already behind us, I think we're at the stage where it's almost impossible not to have ripped someone off or copied someone, because basically we're running out of melodies, and that's not a negative on creativity or about the artists. It's an actual mathematical problem. There are only so many melodies in the world and we are running out. We've almost exhausted all of them, which means that at some point, if music is going to continue to be made, there will be copies. There will be melodies that will be exact replicas of other melodies. So here's something to think about. How is it possible that if a melody is a simple mathematic equation, or a mathematic algorithm, if you will, how is it possible for anybody to own that melody? Because technically speaking, that melody existed before the first person wrote it. It was already there. Maths has existed since before we discovered it. It's always been there. So that melody always existed. So therefore, can a person in fact own a melody as part of copyright? I think this is a two-part answer, and I want to discuss this with you in more detail. So, yes and no. In terms of the actual raw melody, the series of notes that comprise the melody, hook, or motif, they can't be owned by a single person. But I think it has to do with context. So let's say artist A writes a song that uses 4 chords, off the top of my head, D, E, G, C, whatever, right? 4 chords, and they use a melody that runs over those 4 chords. If artist B then writes the exact same 4 chords with the exact same melody, that for me would be grounds for a lawsuit, because that's blatant copying. However, what if artist B had a completely separate chord sequence, but that melody was in the same key and would still fit over the secondary chord sequence? Should artist B then be sued? I think the answer is no. Because ultimately at that point, what they are suing for is a melody, which was not theirs to begin with. That's my argument. They used it, they may have used it first, and I mean, considering recorded music has been around for God knows how many years now, hundreds of years perhaps, that melody that artist A is suing for has probably already been used as well. Should they be sued? I kind of felt a little disheartened watching this, because I thought, well, what's the point? What's the point in writing new music if all you're going to do is just get sued? Because let's say, for instance, you've never heard the original song. You're not a fan of that genre or that artist, or you've just never heard it before. You, in good faith, write a song that you think is original, you release it to the world, and then you get sued for millions of dollars. How is that theft? Because they're suing you over a melody that they can't possibly own, going back to the previous point, because it existed before they wrote it. And second of all, it's not like you've been and downloaded their song or bought their album and then ripped it off. Like, that's unintentional. But it harks back to the first point. They can't sue you for something they don't own in the first place. I think it's a bit of a murky grey area, but the way the law works right now is pretty twisted. And a judge will look on it based on how popular was the original song. So if the original song was like a number one, even if it was in like 1960, but let's say it was a number one, then theoretically speaking, you may have heard that somewhere subconsciously and therefore stolen it, which I think is absolutely ridiculous. Because if it cannot be proven that you've actually stolen it, then how should that be grounds for a lawsuit? I mean, we're not talking $20 here, we're talking millions of dollars. This can end people's careers. For what exactly? Theft of a non-tangible product that they don't own to begin with. It's just ridiculous. So I think a lot of this comes down to, like I was saying earlier, context. The BPM of the song, the vibe of the song, the flow of the song, the chord sequence. There's a lot more that goes into making a song than just a simple 8-note or 12-note melody. There's way more to it than that. And I just don't think the law is, and judges are looking at this in a reasonable manner. I think they're taking a lot of it at face value, and it really isn't that. It needs to be a lot more complex than that. I do think there are cases out there where artists should be sued because it's blatant theft. And I remember a story about Green Day being sued for by Oasis. I can't remember what the songs were. It's When September Ends and Wonderwall, I think. Nigh on identical at some points, and Oasis sued them. If my recollection of the situation is correct, but that is pretty blatant when you listen to the songs back to back. I'm not going to put them in the video because they'll probably sue me next, but here's another point. Is this a case of old artists suing new artists because the older artists are pretty much irrelevant these days? It's like, well, my song's not as popular as it used to be, but how can I make a big cash injection? Oh, I know, I'll sue this new artist because they use 6 notes of my melody. I mean, that's just, I mean, come on. You know, they're killing the industry suing each other like this, like carte blanche suing each other. It's ridiculous. You know, whatever happened to creative freedom? And my last question to you all is, what does the future of the music industry look like? Is this the way we're going to do business now? Is this the way we're going to play ball? We're just going to sue each other? I mean, come on, it ruins it for everybody. And again, I go back to my previous points. If it's a blatant case of theft, then fair enough. You should be sued for that. But if it's not blatant, or it's just a part of a song, or it's just a few notes of a melody, which you don't own in the first place, drop the lawsuits, please. Let's all... It's such a dog-eat-dog industry sometimes, and it's like, how is anybody ever supposed to get ahead? If, you know, I mean, look at, I think it was Tom Petty, I think it says in the TED Talk, it might have been Tom Petty, someone like that. He got sued for some bullshit over a melody that he supposedly stole, and he just stopped writing music for several years because he was like, what's the fucking point? And I totally get it, I get the sentiment. You know, there's X amount of thousand new artists, new songs, new albums, whatever, released per week, per month, per year, right, thousands. You can't tell me that there is not, in all of that, because, I mean, we're not just talking pop music, rock, blues, jazz, hip-hop, dance. I mean, I know dance uses a lot of EDM or whatever, uses a lot of samples, but still. You know, trap, all of the thousands of subgenres, right? You can't tell me amongst all of those releases that there's no two records in there that use part of the same melody or the same melody. There's got to be, right? So let's just cut the crap. Why don't we try and support each other? And, you know, even settle things out of court. I mean, the way they're doing it these days is rather than pay out these massive $1 million sums of money, they're adding co-writers credits onto their songs. So I think Katy Perry added a co-writer's credit on. A few artists have done it now. I mean, how can you have co-written her song when the melody that you supposedly own isn't owned by you to begin with? This is my point. If we can't own melody, how can we sue for it? It's not our property to begin with. We may have a tangible copyright recording, but the thing you're actually suing for is not the recording. It's the melody, which is non-tangible. You can't touch a melody. It's not an actual physical product. It's a series of notes from a mathematic algorithm that you cannot possibly own. That's the point. You can't own it. How can you sue someone else for it? Bullshit. I mean, alright, this goes a lot deeper than this. I'm touching this on a very surface level here, and there's multiple arguments for and against to be made. But I just wanted to share some initial thoughts and bring this problem to light. As I say, I've linked the TED Talk below. I think it's about 20 minutes long, but it's well worth a watch because it's super interesting. Alright, so that's my thoughts on that topic. I would welcome discussion in the comments below. I always try and respond to everybody that leaves a comment. So thanks a lot for watching, and subscribe and hit the notification bell and all the other bullshit if you haven't done already, because it helps me out, it helps the channel out, which is cool, and appreciated. So see you guys in the next one.